Season 3, Episode 13, Deja Q. This is the first Q episode I've done so far, and it's a pretty good one. The episode opens up with the Enterprise trying to assist the people of a planet who are in danger from an impending asteroid collision. Sometimes they call it an asteroid, sometimes they call it a moon. I guess it's both, because it was in orbit around the planet, but now it's crashing into it. So anyway, the moon is falling. And for some reason, the people of this world seem like Asian caricatures, which is a little weird, especially the makeup. I don't know, it's a little sketchy. Anyway, the asteroid is pretty massive, because Geordi says that trying to move it out of the way with the tractor beam would be like an ant trying to push a tricycle. But despite that, they decide to go for it anyway, and Riker tells Worf to contact all the ships in the sector to join them in relief efforts. Which is funny, because no one shows up. So, I guess that's just a text that everyone ignored. But anyway, the plan to move the asteroid out of the way fails, as expected, and suddenly Q shows up, and he's naked, and floating, and he's sideways, too, which means that his dick and balls are hanging sideways. Probably like a wacky wall walker situation. Just trying to paint some kind of visual for you. And Riker looks kind of into it. And right off the bat, the crew thinks the falling asteroid is Q's doing, but that's not really Q's MO. I mean, this is Q's fourth appearance ever in Star Trek. And so far, he's put the crew of the Enterprise on trial for the crimes of humanity. He's offered Riker a chance to join the Q, and he's introduced the Enterprise to the Borg. And he's also shown up naked with his dick and balls hanging out. So, I mean, I don't know why they think that he's capable of genocide. There's nothing to suggest that. But anyway, they're kind of jumping the gun there. But he does say that he's been kicked out of the Q continuum and now he has no powers. Which, admittedly, does sound like kind of a trick. So it's understandable that Picard doesn't really believe it. And he complains about the outfit they gave him, which, I mean, I get it. It looks pretty fucking atrocious. And then he explains that the Continuum kicked him out, turned him into a mortal of his choosing, as punishment for spreading chaos throughout the galaxy. And he chose human and asked them to send him to the Enterprise, because Picard is the closest thing he has to a friend. So Picard throws him in the brig. And then suddenly a white light engulfs the Enterprise, and it looks like J.J. Abrams is making cumsies all over the goddamn place. And Data says they're being probed by something. And Picard, thinking Q had something to do with it, goes to see him. But Q claims that he doesn't know anything about it, which is true. And he says that despite having lost his powers, he still has the knowledge of the Q, and he offers to help Picard with the descending moon situation. And Picard reluctantly accepts. And he assigns Data to keep an eye on Q. And this is some of the best stuff in the episode.
What are you looking at?
I was considering the possibility that you were telling the truth. That you really are human.
It's the ghastly truth, Mr. Data. I can now stub my toe with the best of them.
An irony. It means that you have achieved in disgrace what I have always aspired to be.
And then Q gets a back spasm, and Dr. Crusher shows up and starts fisting him in the asshole. And then Q gets hungry, which makes sense. I mean, I always get hungry after experiencing a few digits. So Data takes him to 10 forward, and he orders 10 chocolate sundaes, because Data says that always makes Troy feel good. And then Q has an encounter with Guinan, and she stabs him with a fork to prove that he's really human. Okay, I know Q is an asshole, but I feel like everyone is being a little too mean to him. I mean, all he's done in this episode is show up and be arrogant. I don't know, I get why they hate him and I get why he's an asshole, but I don't think we need to stab the fucking dude. And it's at this point Q gets attacked by whatever it was that probed them before, the J.J. Abrams shit, and he falls to the ground and he screams for help. And all Guinan can say is, "How the mighty have fallen." See what I'm saying? The crew are just being kind of assholes about this. I mean, he could be dying for all we know. And we're just watching and making quips. Data is the only one who tries to help him, because of course he does. He's Data. And later, Q explains that the thing that attacked him is a species called the Calamarain. And they exist in the form of ionized gas. And they want some payback because Q apparently tormented them. And tormented is a word they keep using. They never go into specifics. So I don't know what the fuck these gassy motherfuckers went through at the hands of Q, but they're pretty pissed off. But they need to put all of that on hold because they need to deal with the falling moon. So Q and Data go to engineering to help Geordi with another attempt to save the planet. And Q is once again attacked by the Calamarain, and once again Data is the only one who tries to help. But this time, Data is injured in the attempt. And the crew has just about had it with Q's shit at this point. And he finally admits that he makes for a pretty shitty human. And this is sort of his way of thanking and apologizing to Data.
We're recalibrating his language circuits so he can't talk yet.
There are creatures in the universe who would consider you the ultimate achievement, android. No feelings, no emotions, no pain. And yet you covet those qualities of humanity. Believe me, you're missing nothing. But if it means anything to you, you're a better human than I.
And then Q decides that he's going to sacrifice himself to the Calamarain so that they'll leave the Enterprise alone. And then Corbin Burnson shows up as another Q, which is fucking weird.
Hey guys, I got some good news for you. This morning at 9:10 a.m., I activated myself.
And basically he's ready to forgive Q and give him his powers back because he just committed a selfless act. I'm not sure how that absolves him of everything he did, but apparently it does. And Q kind of teleports the Calamarain away someplace else. And then he brings a fucking mariachi band on the Enterprise. And then he tries to get Riker laid. And Riker says this, which we know is a fucking lie. I mean, anybody remember Minuet? Anyway, then Q decides to give Data a parting gift.
I do not know. But it was a wonderful feeling.
Okay, I mean, I'm a little surprised that didn't overload his positronic brain or something. But, you know, whatever. He enjoyed it. And then Q restores the moon to its original orbit, which surprises the crew. And that's basically it. It's a very good episode. It's a little strange that the crew thinks that Q is responsible for the impending genocide of a species. Like I said earlier, it's not really his thing. But other than that, it's really solid. And I like to think this experience changed Q a little bit going forward because he's a little less villainous in future encounters. He's a little bit more, I don't know, he's a little nicer to the crew for the most part anyway. And I always like the philosophical debates between Picard and Q about humanity. That's always great. But anyway, that's basically all I got for now. And just remember, if an omnipotent being shows up with his dick and balls hanging out, just try to be a little patient with him. He's going to be a bit of a dickhead, but give him some chocolate sundaes. Fist him in the butt when necessary. Don't stab him. you know, and be a little nice, because in the long run, it might help.